So today we are going to see about the pest of castor and mustard. So what is the scientific name of castor? Anybody? Three of you. What is the scientific name of castor? Okay, it is Ricinus communis. So we are going to see about the pest of castor and mustard. The scientific name is Brassica napus. So the first pest, it is castor shoot and capsule borer. The scientific name, it is Dicrocosis or Cognogethes punctiferalis. It comes under family Crambidae and order Lepidoptera. So this pest, it is also known as peach yellow mote, and it is a potential pest of castor occurring in flowering stage as well as during the time of maturity of capsules. So this pest is also known to attack ginger, cardamom, turmeric, and mango inflorescence, then sorghum ears, and so on. So let's come to the symptom or nature of damage of this pest. So if you see, as I said before, the insect, it has been noted to attack the crop only in the flowering stage and at the time of maturity of the capsules. So when the egg is laid on the capsules, the caterpillar, it will start hatching and start feeding on the greenish coat of the capsule, which is in between the warts. And then what it will do is, it will enter the capsule invariably by boring at the pedicellar or stigmatic end of the capsule. And at the site of feeding, it will form a silken gallery in which the excreta and also the frass get accumulated. And also it will form a protective covering to the larva. So as it grows, this pest will bore into the castor bean through the peduncle portion, and they will feed on the inner content. So the biodynamics of this pest is that the medium-sized adult moth, it will be having small black dots on pale yellowish wings, and it will lay pinkish oval flat eggs. It will lay singly or in groups of two or three, mostly in between the warts or just below the style on the ovary. And also it is known to lay eggs on the tender developing capsules. So on a single panicle, a maximum of 20 eggs may be noticed, and the incubation period will be from 6 to 7 days. So the fully grown larva, it will be pale greenish in color with a pinkish wash, that is pinkish cover dorsally, and also they will be having fine hairs arising on warts all over the body. And also the head and the prothoracic shield of this pest larvae will be brown in color, and its larval stage may be seen under a cover of silk and also frass or excreta, which will extend between the capsules. And this pest is known to pupate inside the damaged stem, peduncle, or capsule in a thin silken cocoon, and it emerges as adult in 7 to 10 days, and the whole life cycle ranges from 25 to 33 days. And for management, we have to collect and destroy the infested shoots and capsules. And we have to conserve the natural enemies in the field itself. The natural enemies that are present in field is parasitoids like Brachon breviconis, Brachymeria, then predators like Chrysoberla, ladybird, then reduvid bug, spider, red ant, robber fly, black drongo, common miner, that is two birds, then big-eyed bug, earwig, so on. And if the infestation is more, then you have to go on for spraying like Malathion and Carbaryl. And the next pest, it is Semilooper, Castor Semilooper. And the scientific name, it is Acacia genata, belongs to the family Noctuidae and order Lepidoptera. So this plant is also known to attack rose, pomegranate, Tridax procubens, then Euphorbia hirta, and also Euphorbia hypercifolia. So coming to the symptom, The freshly hatched larvae, it will feed gregariously and it will start scraping the chlorophyll. And after scraping, it will soon disperse all around the plants. Sometimes the feeding is so heavy that only the petioles and branches will be left behind. And the caterpillar also known to feed on the leaves, and it will cause sometimes complete devastation of the crops. And it subsequently leads to defoliation. So this Castor semilupar is a defoliator. And next, about the biology of the pest. The female moth, it will lays around 450 blue-green rounded eggs, and also the eggs will be sculptured singly on the leaves of the castor plant. And also the eggs will be laid singly on both sides of the leaves. There will be 4 to 6 eggs will be observed on each leaf. And the eggs, when freshly laid, will be round, pale green in color. And also it will measure about 0.9 mm in diameter. There will be, and also the corium, that is the outermost covering, protective covering, will be full of ridges and furrows. And the egg will be convex on the upper surface and it will be concave on the below surface. And the incubation period of the egg, it will vary from 2 to 5 days. Next is larva. So the newly hatched caterpillar, it will be yellowish in color, yellowish green in color, with a light brown head, and the thorax, it will be measuring about, head and thorax will be light brown in color, and the newly hatched larva, it will measure about 3.5 mm long. And the fully grown larva, it will be dull grayish in color. And the fully grown, it will be about 60 to 70 mm long. And there will be 5 distinct larval instars. And the larval period, it will last from 12 to 13 days. And the pupation, it will take place either in the soil amidst the fallen leaves, or sometimes it may also see on the folded leaves on the plants. And the pupal period, it will last for about 10 to 27 days. And coming to the adult, you can observe a grayish brown in color moth, and they will be having a pale reddish brown patch forewings, and the black in the black hind wings, they will be having white stripes in the middle, and also, as you can see in the picture, they will be having a white color patch in the middle, and also there will be 3 large white spots on the outer margin. So next is the management. So you have to pick the larva up, and you have to destroy it. Then you have to maintain the natural enemies like telonomas, then detrastichus, then also the braconid parasite like Micropleurites officinae. This parasite is a larval parasite, and that too are egg parasitoids. So once this braconid parasitoid comes out from the pest, what you can observe is that on the ventral aspect of the posterior end of this host caterpillar, you can see the cocoons of this braconid parasitoids. And you can also install bird perches, which should be like 10 numbers per hectare. Then you can go for a neem oil application or a Bacillus thuringiensis application. And if the pest attack is more, then you have to go on for the spraying of insecticide like Malathion, Carbaryl, and also you can use a neem seed kernel extract plus neem oil, that is botanical extracts. So next it is the Castor slug caterpillar. So this pest is actually very common in the southern region of the country, like in Chennai, and also this pest damaged the castor plant sporadically. So the scientific name is Parasa lepida and belongs to the family Cochlididae and order Lepidoptera. So it is also known to attack coconut, pomegranate, mango, palmyra, citrus, and also wood apple. So coming to the symptom, the caterpillar, it will be spiny, and when touches, it will cause irritation to the skin. So this larvae, it is known to feed gregariously on the leaves of castor, and then later it will disperse all over the entire plant. This caterpillar also known to cause defoliation, and they will leave only the midrib and veins at last. And coming to the biology of the pest, So the adult moth, it will be like green color. They will be having green wings with a prominent dark patch at the base of each forewing, as you can see here. So it will be laying flat, shiny scaly eggs on the undersurface of the leaves in clusters. And also the larva, it will become fully grown in about 6 weeks, I think. And it will be having greenish body, and also it will be having white color lines, and also they will be having scolae all over their body, and they will be having interrupted blue stripes on the dorsum. And because of this blue stripes on their dorsum, they are known as blue striped nettle grub. And the name slug caterpillar comes because they will move like a slug. That is, they will be very slow and sluggish in nature. And the pupation, they will pupate in a hard grayish cocoon, and it will take about 3 to 5 weeks for the adult to emerge. So coming to the management, you have to conserve the predators, as I have given all these, you have to by heart it. Then you have to pick up the gregarious caterpillar, and you have to destroy it in water with a film of kerosene. Then you can also spray chlorpyrifos or quinolones. So next it is tussock caterpillar, that is Orgia postica, that comes under the family Limantridae and the order Lepidoptera. So this pest is also a defoliator, and the males of this particular pest, it is known to attract to the females during the dusk, and after mating, it will lay a cream-colored subspherical eggs and in a mass on the cocoon itself. And the larvae, it will hatch out from the eggs in 7 days. The larval period, it will be around 16 days and 19 days in a female. And here, the fully grown larva, it will be having a brown head. And the prothorax, it will be having a pair of long pencils of hairs. It will be projecting forward, and the larva will be about 27 mm long. And also there, you can observe tuft of yellowish hairs laterally on first two abdominal segments, then yellowish tuft of hairs dorsally on the first four abdominal segments, and also long brown hairs dorsally from the eighth abdominal segment. So you can see, so this is the peculiar character of this pest larvae. And also it will pupate in a transparent silken cocoon that is formed inside the leaf fold itself. So here the male, it will be having brownish wings, but the female will be apterous. It is one of the peculiar characteristics of this pest, that is the female will be apterous. So next is the hairy caterpillar. So there are three hairy caterpillar known to attack this pest, and three of them belongs to the family Limantridae and order Lepidoptera. So the first pest, the first hairy caterpillar, it is Euproctis fraterna. So here the yellowish moth, they will be having tail transverse line on four wings, and it will lay flat eggs. And the egg will be yellowish in color, and they will mostly lay the eggs on the lower surface of the leaves, and also they will cover them with the yellowish hair. And the fully grown larva, it will possess a red head with white hairs around, and also they will be having a long pre-anal tuft. And it is known to pupate on the egg plant itself in a cocoon of yellowish hair. So next is Portacea scintillans. So this pest, this larva is known to feed also on cotton and red gram also. So they will be having yellowish brown head, and you can also observe a yellow dorsal stripe with a central red line on the body and a tuft of black hairs dorsally on the first three abdominal segments. So in the first three abdominal segments, I have not mentioned here, but in the first three abdominal segments, you can see tuft of black hairs, and the adult, it will be yellowish in color with spots on the edges of forewings. So their life cycle will be also similar to the Euproctus fraterna. And the next one, it is Dasychira mendosa. So the moth, it will be yellowish in color. Here, the peculiar character of larva is that their prolex will be having crimson colored prolex. And also these larvae will be grayish brown in color with dark prothoracic, and they will be also having pre-anal tuft. So next is the woolly bat, that is Pericalia raceni, that belongs to the family Arctidae and order Lepidoptera. So the host plant it is known to attack is banana, pumpkin, gingerly, moringa, agathe, cotton, field bean, and also coccinea. So this pest is also a defoliator. And coming to the identification of the pest, they are actually blackish brown larvae, and they will be having red head, and also they will be having thick hairs which will be arising on the bluish warts that is found on the all over its body. So it is known to pupate in a cocoon of silken hairs, and the adult, it will be gray colored moth, and they will be having dark spots on the pinkish hind wings. So you can observe here they will be having pinkish hind wings. That is the identification mark of this pest. So next it is the Castor spiny caterpillar. So the scientific name is Ergolis merionae. And this pest is a specific pest of castor. That is, it is known to attack only on castor. And the family is Nymphalidae and the order Lepidoptera. So this is also a defoliator. And this larva, it is known to feed by remaining on the upper surface of the leaves itself. So they will be having structured eggs that are laid singly on the eggs. And the caterpillar, it is known to have short branching hairs of hairs in groups all over its body, and their body will be greenish in color. And the pupae, it will be brown in color, and also the cocoon, it is known to made of silk and hairs of this pest. And the adult, it will be brown in color, and they will be having wavy thin lines all over their wings. And for management, you have to go for cypermethrin or monocrotophlus. That is, all the pests that I mentioned, all the defoliators, if you see on the field, then you have to control the early stage larvae itself using neem seed kernel extract, or you have to spray chlorpyrifos. And you can also go for spraying of the cypermethrin at the later stages. So next is the Bihar hairy caterpillar. So it is Spilosoma oblique. So this pest, it is known to attack the groundnut also. So the scientific name is Spilosoma oblique. This pest, it is normally occur during late season. That is, it has sun during October to December. It will be very much in excess, and the symptom is that the young larvae, it will feed gregariously mostly on the undersurface of the leaves, and they are also known to feed on leaves, and it will cause loss by way of defoliation. And in severe cases, you can observe only the stem that is left behind. And in defoliated crops, it is also known to feed on the capsules. So the egg, that is the biology, the egg, the female will lay eggs in masses on the lower surface of the leaves. And the larvae, it will be pale yellow colored with yellow hair all over the body. They are actually polyphagous pests that will feed on leaves, and also they will cause loss by way of defoliation. And in severe cases, this larvae, it will leave only stems, as I said before. And the pupa, it will pupate in leaf litter that is close to the plants. And also they will be having several generation per year. That is, they are multi-volatile in nature. And the adult, it will be reddish brown in color with black spots. And both the wings will be pinkish color, and they will be possessing black spots. So for management, you have to conserve the predators. Then you have to go for deep summer plowing. Then you have to avoid pre-monsoon sowing, because this pre-monsoon is the conducive environment to the particular pest, and you have to use only optimum seed rate. Then adequate plant spacing, as mentioned in the crop production, should be provided, and you have to intercrop this plant with PGNP variety or maize. So this is actually given because this is also known to attack soybean. So they have given that you have to intercrop with PGNP or maize or sorghum at the ratio of 4:2. And as always, you have to collect and destroy the infected parts or egg masses and also the young larvae. So for you have to maintain field sanitation also. It is also an important cultural practice. Then you can install a light trap in order to catch the adults. Then you can go for applying chemicals if the pest is in excess, and like chlorpyrifos, trisophos, quinolfos. Then you can also go for botanical spraying like neem seed kernel extract and also neem oil. So the red hairy caterpillar and also the tobacco caterpillar, also known to attack this pest. So can anyone say the scientific name of red hairy caterpillar? Hello, red hairy caterpillar scientific name? It is Amsecta albistriga and Amsecta morula. Yeah. Then tobacco caterpillar. Scientific name. You can unmute yourself. Hello.
Spodoptera lituria.
Okay. So next is the sucking pest. So it is first one. It is the leafhopper, Empusca flavins. So they comes under family Cicadellidae and order Hemiptera. So this castor jacet, it is actually a minor pest, and it is mostly recorded from Bihar, Tamil Nadu and also Assam. So this pest is also known to attack tea. And coming to the damage symptoms, the nymphs and adults, both the nymphs and adults, they are known to suck the sap usually from the undersurface of the leaves. And they will inject the toxin that will cause curling of leaf edges. And also the leaves, it will turn red or brown in color. Gradually the leaves, they will dry up and they will shed. And the leaf margin, they will become yellow. And you can also observe that the curling area will also turn into red or brown. So next, coming to the biology of the pest, the female will insert its egg into leaf veins on the underside of the leaves, and the egg will hatch in about 6 to 10 days, and the nymphal period, it will last for 7 to 9 days. Then coming to the nymphal stage, the nymphs, it will be pale greenish in color, almost it will be translucent, and also they will walk diagonally. So it is a peculiar character of this Cicadellidae family, that is, they will walk diagonally. And also the nymphal stage, it will last for 7 to 21 days. So the adults, they will emerge and it will be greenish yellow in color, and they will be wedge shaped with a pair of black spots on vertex, and also there will be a black spot on each of the forewings. And the adult stage, it will last for 35 to 50 days, and there will be a total of 7 to 8 generation in a year, that it is also a multi-volatile. And for management, you can go for seed treatment with imidacloprid or carbosulfone, and also you can apply chemical like monocrotophers in the stem, which will protect the crop from most of the sucking pests. Then next is you can also go for spraying of monocrotophers or dimethoate. So next is the castor whitefly, that is Trialirrhodes ricini, that comes under the family Aleurodidae and order Hemiptera. So it is also known to attack cotton. And coming to the damage symptom, both the nymphs and the adults, they are known to suck sap from the leaves. This will make the leaves appear sick, and also the sooty mold, it will be developed when the whitefly infestation is severe. So the water soaked spots on the leaves can be seen, and gradually the leaves will become yellow and get dried up. Then you can also observe that the plant growth will be stunted in a severe case, and also you can observe shedding of the fruiting bodies. So next is the biology of the insect. The egg, the female will lay shiny white long eggs in small clusters or scattered about on the underside of the tender leaf. And the nymphs, the egg, it will hatch into nymphs which settle on the leaves, and along with the adults, it will suck the sap from the leaves. Both the nymphs and the pupa will be yellowish in color. And the adult fly, it will be having white wings and yellow body, and also their legs and antenna will be pale white in color. It is actually a very tiny insect, that a little less than a diameter, millimeter in length. So management, you have to conserve the natural enemies, then you have to go on installing the yellow sticky trap. This will be coated with greasy or sticky oily materials. Then if the attack is more, then you have to go for spraying with triazophores or acephate, that is systemic insecticide you have to go for. Then you can also spray neem products, that is neem oil or neem seed kernel extract, with any sticky material. Then you have to avoid the synthetic pyrethroid, but because already in many places it has been reported that the whitefly is known to be resistant to this synthetic pyrethroid, and flare up of this pest is seen when this synthetic pyrethroid is sprayed. So next it is cotton thrips, that is Retithrips cereacus, that belongs to the family Thripidae and order Thysanoptera, and this pest is known to attack cotton and also rose. And damage symptom, both the adults and nymphs, they are known to feed on the upper and also on the lower surface of the leaves, and the terminal leaves, it will crinkle and it will appear silvery. So if the infestation is severe, then the plants will also show stunted growth, and the injury, it will result in development of dull yellowish green patches on the upper surface, as brown necrotic areas on the lower surface. So upper surface you can see yellowish green patches, and lower surface you can see brown necrotic areas. And also the leaves, it is known to get curled, and also the plants will get stunted. So the biology, the adults and nymphs will be very tiny, and the pinkish nymphs, and there will be black adult with fringed eggs you can see all over the plants. And for management, you have to go for spraying of insecticide like dimethoate, methyl odometone, and monocrotophers. You can also go for a combination of insects like monocrotophers along with neem oil and soap powder. Next, it is mite. That is U. tetranychus species or Tetranychus tellarius. It belongs to the family Tetranychidae and order Acarina. So these nymphs and adults, they are known to suck the sap from the undersurface of the leaves by constructing silken galleries, and also during severe infestation, you can observe white blotches will be formed. And on the upper surface of the leaves, white blotches will be formed on the upper surface of the leaves. And in severe attack, the mites are also seen on the upper surface. That is the main symptom will be white blotches. And if the mite infestation is more, then you have to go for dusting of this fine sulfur. And also you have to go for spraying with Dicofol and Profenofos. So next we are going to see the pest of mustard. So as I said, the mustard, the scientific name is Brassicae napus. So the major pest is this mustard aphid, and their scientific name is Lipaphis erythymi, and they belongs to the family Aphididae. And let's move on to the damage symptom. Both the nymphs and adults, they will suck the sap from leaves, buds, and also pods, and you can observe curling in the infested leaves. And at advanced stage, the plants will be withering and they also will die. You can also see sooty mold, which grow on the honeydew excreted by this insect, and the plants at severe condition will remain stunted. So moving on to the biology, the eggs, they will be white in color and they are laid along the veins of the leaves. The nymphs that are hatches will be having four nymphal stages, and the general appearance of each stage will be similar except for increase in size during subsequent instance. And the adults, it will be small, soft-bodied and pear-shaped insect, and it will be having a cornicles. So where this cornicle is present? Cornicles are present at? Hello? Okay. Actually, this cornicle, it is a wax secreting tubes. It will be projecting out from the fifth or sixth abdominal segment of the aphid. So this question may be asked in JRF exam also. So the wingless female will be yellowish green in color, or gray color, or olive green in color. They will be also having a white waxy bloom covering the body. And the winged female, it will be dusky green in color. That is, they will be having dusky green abdomen, and also they will be having dark lateral stripe that will be separating the body segment as well as this wing veins. And the male aphid, they will be olive green to brown in color.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what is the use of cornicles in insects, ma'am?
They in order to protect them from the enemies.
Okay, thank you, madam.
So next it is the management strategies. So they will use you can use tolerant varieties like JM1 or RK9501, and you have to destroy the affected plants. Then you have to go on for a sowing during October season. That is, the conducive season will be like from, as I said, it will be January season. So before itself, you have to sow this. Then you have to go for a yellow sticky trap in order to avoid, in order to monitor this aphid population. Then you have to conserve the natural enemies. Then you have to go for a spraying of this entomopathogenic fungus like Cephalosporium or Endoptera, and also Verticillium lecani. Then several species of syrphid, that is, these predators should also be conserved in the field itself. Some braconid parasite like Diaraitella rapae, it is also a very active biological agent against this pest. Then you have to go for release of the lace wings like Chrysoperla carnea. Then predatory birds are also known to feed on this aphids. Then if the pest attack is more, then you have to go for insecticide spraying. Next is the mustard sawfly. So the scientific name, it is Atelia lugens proxima, and the family Tenthridae. Let's move on to the damage symptom. So initially the larva, it is known to nibble the leaves, and later it will feed from the margin towards the midrib. So it is the peculiar symptom of this pest. And also the adults are known to lay the eggs on the margin itself. So the larvae, it is known to feed from margin towards the midrib. And the grub, it causes numerous short holes, and also riddled. The entire leaves will be riddled by voracious feeding. And also they are known to devour the epidermis of the shoot, that will result in drying up of seedlings and failure to bear the seeds in older plants. So the yield loss will be up to 5 to 18%. And in severe case at the seedling stage, the crop has to be re-sown. So next is the biology. The eggs will be spherical in shape, and it will be about 0.5 mm in diameter. And also it will be light bluish green in color. So the larva, it will hatch, and it will be greenish black in color and with a wrinkled body. And another peculiar character is that this larvae, this grub is known to have 8 abdominal legs. They will be having 8 abdominal legs. So this question is repeatedly asked in many competitive exams. So the larva, it will be having 6 instars, and they will voraciously feed on the leaves. And the pupation, it will takes place in the leaf itself, and the pupa, it will look like sand particles, and it will be having the salivary secretion of the larva. And the pupal stage, it will last for about 11 to 12 days. And after that, the adult will emerge, which will be orange bodied, and it will be also having smoky transparent wings. And this pest is known to be active during the seedling stage actually. And the next is the management. So you have to go for summer plowing. I'm sorry, the pupa, it is known to be seen in the soil also. So in order to destroy the pupa, you have to go for summer plowing. Then early sowing, it should be avoided. It should be done in order to prevent the pest conducive environment. And you have to maintain clean cultivation. That is, the field sanitation should be maintained. Then you have to apply irrigation in seedling stage. So that is very much crucial for the management of this sawfly. And then you have to collect and destroy the grubs. Then you have to conserve the parasitoid of this grub, that is Perillus cingulator, and also another bacterium that is known to attack this pest is Serratia marescens. And you can also go for bitter gourd seed soil emulsion, that is this bitter gourd is known to be antifidant to this pest. Then you can go for spraying of Malathion and Phenolphos. So next is the painted bug, Bagrada cruciferarum. This is a serious pest in North India. So they belongs to the family Pentatomidae and order Hemiptera. So this the adults and nymphs, it is known to suck the sap from all parts of the plants, and the young plants which is attacked by this pest will wilt and also wither as a result of this pest attack. And the adult bugs, it will excrete a resinous substance which will spoil the pot. So that is why they are known as painted bug. And the quality and quantity of the yield is also affected when the grown-up plants are infected. And the harvested crops in threshing is also known to be infected by this plant. So here the important point is that the resinous substance which will spoil the pods. So this is why they are named as painted bug. So next it is the biology. So the egg, the female, it will lay the painted bug, it will lay its egg in clusters on leaves or on the soil underneath the host plant. So the eggs will be barrel shaped, and initially it will be white, and then gradually it will turn into orange with age. And a single female, it can lay as many eggs, that is 100 eggs within 2 to 3 weeks. And also the incubation period, it will be about 5 to 8 days. And the nymph will emerge, and it will pass through 5 stages, changing color from bright orange to red with the dark markings. Gradually, it will acquire the coloration of the adult. Initially, they will be not having any wings, but the wings will also gradually develop as the nymphs grow. Then you can also observe the wing pads in the last insta nymphs. Then the adult bug, it will be typically shield shaped, that is 5 to 7 mm long, and also they 3 to 4 mm broad. And the upper surface will be having a mixture of black, white, and also orange marking, as you can see in the picture. This will give the insect its common name, that is painted bug. And the life cycle, it lasts for about 3 to 4 weeks, and several generation may occur. That is, it is also a multi-volatile pest. And the period of activity of this painted bug will be during September season. Then for management, you have to go for a deep plowing in order to expose the egg. And the early sowing is needed in order to avoid the pest attack. Then you have to go for proper irrigation during the 4th week after sowing. And you also have to go for quick threshing, as it is known to affect the harvested crop also. And you have to burn the remains of mustard crop that are seen in the field, so that the stages of insect will not be carried over to the next season. And the bug, it will usually congregate on the leaves and stem, which can be jerked to dislodge. And after that, they should be killed in kerosinized water. You can also conserve biocontrol agents like aloe vera species. Then you have to go for spraying of this crop with Malathion or dinitrate. So next is the leaf webber, that is Crocidolomia binotalis. So this is also known as larger moth of this mustard, and they belongs to the family Crambidae and order Lepidoptera. So this newly hatched larvae, they will feed initially on the chlorophyll of young leaves, and later on they will feed on the older leaves, then buds, and also on pods. They will also make webbings and live, and they will live within this webbings. And severely attacked plants are known to be defoliated, and also the seeds in the pods are also eaten away by this pest. And the biology, the female moth, it lays eggs in masses of about 40 to 100 on underside of the leaves, and this will hatch within 5 to 15 days. And the larva that emerges will web together the foliage and feeds on the leaves. And in mustard, it is known to feed on flowers and pods, it is also known to attack on cabbage and cauliflower. And in cabbage and cauliflower, it is known to attack the flower heads. And the caterpillar, it bears a red head with brown longitudinal stripes. And they will be also having rows of tubercles on the body. And this larval period, it will be lasting for 24 to 27 days. And the pupation, it will take place in a cocoon within the webbed leaves. And the pupal period will be about 14 to 40 days. And the adult, it will be light brown. They will be small in size, and also they will be having light brownish forewings. And the hindwings will be white with brown markings on the margin. And for management, you have to go for spraying only. That is, you can use Forcelain or Fenvalerate. As this is a minor pest, no need for taking up any of the management practices also. So next is the diamond back moth. Actually, this moth is known to attack the Brassicaceae, and they belongs to the family Plutella Psilotella, and belongs to the family Rutellidae and order Lepidoptera. So they are also known to attack on cabbage and cauliflower. So the damage symptom, they will feed on the foliage and the leaves, it will get it will be having a withered appearance on the earlier stage, but in later stage this larvae, it is known to bore holes in the leaves and it also eaten up the leaves completely, and it is also known to bore into the pods and also feeds the developing seeds. So they will also form skeletonization in the leaves and also they will bore into the pods and feeds on the developing seeds. And coming to the biology of this pest, the egg, it will be minute yellow colored one and they will lay singly or also in groups under the surface of the leaves. So the egg, it will hatch in about 7 days and the larva will emerge and it will last for about 14 days and the larva, it will be pale yellowish green color and the pupa, it will take place on the foliage in a transparent cocoon. As you see in the picture, there will be a transparent cocoon that is being constructed by this pest. And the pupal period, it will be from, it will be about 7 days. And the adult, it will be a small grayish brown moth with three white triangular spots along the narrow wings. So because of this, the presence of this triangular spot, which will be appeared as a diamond shape during the rest position. So that is why this pest is known as diamond back moth. The hind wings, it will be having fringes of long fine hairs. So for management, you have to go for setting up of this pheromone trap in order to monitor the moth activity. Then you have to collect and destroy the gregarious larvae. And also you have to conserve the natural enemy, that is Cortesia plutella, and also another larval parasite, that is Diadigma insulare. And you can also go for spraying of Malathion dust when the pest is in excess. And also it is known that most of the insecticide, this pest is known to be resistant. And you also have to apply, you can also apply Bacillus thuringiensis. And next is the cabbage head borer, that is Helula undalis. So this is also known to attack mustard leaf. This is actually a cabbage head borer pest, but it is also known to attack the mustard. So it belongs to the family Crambidae and order Lepidoptera. So let's see the nature of damage. So here what happens is the newly hatched, that the caterpillar, it will initially mine the leaves and it will make the leaves white papery like appearance, and then later it will feed on the leaves and also it is known to bore into stems. At the entrance hole, it is covered with silken excreta. So the major symptom is it will mine, that will cause white papery appearance. Then again it will feed on the leaves and will bore into the stem, and the entrance holes, it will be covered with silken excreta. So the biology, the female moth, it will lay yellowish shiny eggs on leaves, and the egg, it will hatch in about 4 days, and the larva, the caterpillar will become fully grown in about 9 days, and the fully grown larva will about 12 to 15 mm in size. So the grayish yellow caterpillar will be having 7 purplish brown longitudinal stripes on the body. That is again a identification mark of this larvae. And the pupa, it is known to be pupate in the larval burrow itself, and also it will pupate in the soil. And the pupal period, it will be about 6 days, and the adult, once it emerges, will be pale yellowish brown in color, and they will be having gray wavy markings on the forewings. And for management, you have to go for the collection of this larvae and destruct it. Then also you can go for spraying of this Malathion dust. So that's what. That's all for today's class. So, what all pest Ashok sir covered for you? Can anyone say? Hello? Hello? Yes, you can unmute and you can. Hello. Nirlepa or Gausi, Sindhu, anyone can answer? Hello. Yes, Sindhu. Ashok sir, covered what all pest?
Ma'am, I think beneficial insects, ma'am.
Okay, he didn't cover any pest.
Actually, I didn't attend last class, ma'am. I think sir taken for lac insect, ma'am. Class for lac insect.
Okay, he didn't cover sorghum.
No, ma'am.
Okay.
Actually, I don't know exactly, but okay. I think last class was lac insect, ma'am.
Lac insect. Okay. So, shall I ask questions? Hello? You will answer or? Hello? Okay, shall I end the class?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.